Hey there, Unity developers. Do you want a game which has detailed user-based analytics? A game which you can tweak and run experiments on remotely? A game which is social and shareable from the start? Well, you've come to the right place. Let's get started with Firebase and Unity on this episode of Firecasts. We're going to cover 5 steps to go from an empty Unity game to a game that's ready to be shipped on iOS and Android. First, we'll open up a Unity project. Second, we'll download the Firebase SDK. Third, we'll install that Firebase SDK into Unity. Fourth, we'll configure a new Firebase project to be used in our Unity game. And fifth, we'll compile our game for iOS and Android. Are you ready? Let's get started. First, open up the Unity editor. In our case, we'll be making a new game, but don't worry if you already have an existing game which you want to add Firebase to. The process is going to be exactly the same. Just open up your existing game instead of making a new one like I'm doing. Once we've opened our project, we'll see the editor with the inspector scene view and everything else you'd expect. Note the empty inspector on the right side. This is where our Firebase panel will live once the SDK is installed. But before Firebase can start adding cool features to Unity, we need to install Firebase. Let's hop over to the Firebase docs and download the latest Firebase SDK for Unity. At this point, you probably already know if you want to make an iOS game or an Android game or both. But the great part about Unity is that we can make a game that works for both these platforms with only one code base. This means that regardless of the mobile platform you want to build for, you'll download just the one SDK, the Firebase SDK, for Unity. This download comes as a zip, and when you extract it, you'll see a bunch of files with a .unity package extension. Let's take a second to talk about Unity asset packages. These packages are a standard way in the Unity world to distribute reusable code. If you're familiar with other programming tools, you've probably included an external library into a project. Unity asset packages are a lot like this. It's a way to distribute things for other developers to use. It's worth understanding that a Unity asset package can contain lots of different stuff. It's not just code like a normal library. Asset packages can contain images, textures, 3D models, examples, and yes, code. Firebase has a lot of features, and you don't need to use all of them in your game. Each Firebase feature has its own asset package. So if you only want to use Firebase Analytics or you only want to use Firebase Database, you can include just that package. Let's go with the simplest feature to implement, Firebase Analytics. In the Unity editor, go to Assets, Import Package, Custom Package. Then browse to where you extracted the Firebase SDK and select the firebaseanalytics.unity package file. Unity will take a moment to extract the package, then you'll be prompted to select which files from the package you want to import. We can see this asset package taking advantage of the fact that asset packages can contain non-code assets. The first thing to show up in this package are a bunch of icons which are used for the Unity Editor plugin. We don't need to pick and choose what to import here, so just click Import and let Unity do its magic. After another second, you'll be back in the Unity Editor, but it'll have a few key changes. First, your assets folder will now contain some new folders, and second, your editor now has the Firebase plugin enabled. Once the spinner in the bottom right is stopped, you'll be able to start using Firebase. If you haven't already, it's a good time to save your Unity scene. If you're working off a new project, this won't be done automatically. So just go to File, Save Scene. This will save the scene in your project, and if you don't know what to call it, just call it something exciting and original like Game. Once we have a saved scene, we can bring out the Firebase pane in our editor. In your menu, go to Window and click on Firebase. Now, depending on your editor setup, the Firebase pane may show up as a floating window, or it may show up near the Inspector tab. Just find it wherever it is. The Firebase plugin will help you get started with any Firebase feature by linking you to setup guides, code samples, and the API reference. You'll notice the very first thing the plugin shows is advice on connecting your game to your Firebase project's Android or iOS app. Like I talked about before, Unity has the ability to build games for iOS and Android. Firebase and Unity both work great on these platforms, but there is some minor work needed to set up both of these platforms for your Firebase and Unity project. Let's start by making a new project on the Firebase console at firebase.google.com. Once you've created a project, you'll be greeted with a screen asking you if you'd like to make an iOS app, an Android app, or a web app. A Firebase project may contain many apps. This means you'll only need one Firebase project, even if you're building both an Android and iOS version of the same game. I'll be showing you how to build a cross-platform game, but if you're only interested in iOS or Android, you can just do that one. Let's click on the Add Firebase to your iOS app button. We'll enter a few basic details, and then on step two, it'll download a Google Services.plist file. This is a configuration file that will tell the Firebase Unity SDK what project to connect to. Back in Unity, we'll drag this plist file into the root of our assets folder, and the Firebase SDK will automatically detect it when we build our app for iOS. This is another situation when you need to watch that spinner in the bottom right and make sure it's completed. If you want to do the same thing on Android, then click on the Add Firebase to your Android app button and enter that same basic information. And the second step, you'll be given a Google Services.json file. And just like with the plist, we'll drag this file into the root of our assets folder in Unity. Once you've gotten your configurations in place, you'll be able to go into your File, Build and Run menu, and build your game. Switching between platforms is as easy as selecting the Switch Platform buttons in the Build Settings menu. Once we've deployed our game, the debug messages will show us that Firebase Analytics is enabled and reporting back to your console. Congrats! You've gotten your first Firebase library up and running inside of your Unity game. But this is really just the start. There's a lot more Firebase can do inside of Unity, like saving your users' data to the cloud with the real-time database, tweaking gameplay settings on the fly with Firebase Remote Config, adding notification support with Firebase Cloud Messaging, and a whole lot more. If you want to learn more about what Firebase and Unity can do together, check out our Unity docs linked in the description below and subscribe to the Firebase YouTube channel. In the meantime, thanks for watching, and I'm heading back to the arcade.